Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are today Monday, February 6th, 2017. Thank you so much for the people who are watching this video, and thank you so much for the people who have subscribed to my channel. So as I mentioned to you before, the particular videos that I want to bring forth to my channel are the videos that I want to work on. They are videos that are probably not going to be off my head. However, I feel like sometimes, you know, just some videos just speak through you, or some topics just come through you, and I just feel like I don't want to withhold from that. And today is such a day. I really want to come forward and talk about being motivated to leave your job and to pursue your passion. And one of the reasons that I actually want to talk about that is because this morning when I woke up, you know, I was checking my, you know, my stuff, my emails and things of the sort. And I usually check, I have my notification for YouTube as well. And one of the YouTubers that I subscribe to, her name is Curves on the Moves. She actually has a video that she put out. And in that particular video, she was describing how she wanted to take some time off from social media, how she was going through into a phase where she felt stuck. She was also mentioning the fact that her current job, she's been in it for 11 years, but she didn't like the job. She was grateful for it. And she was like, don't ask me how I've been in there for 11 years, but this is not what I want to do. This is not, you know, where I want to be. And I know it, but how I don't know how to move out of that and how to go forward with what it is that my heart is telling me to do. And you're just like, you know, when... I don't know, for people who make videos, sometimes it's like you watch someone who was going through something and you want to reach out. So as she was like talking about it, all I wanted to do was hug her and to talk to her. But then I said to myself, like, this is a good opportunity to go ahead and talk about myself and to talk about, you know, what I'm doing and the risk that I'm taking. Now, the first thing that I want to talk to you about, that it's easy. It's very, very easy to get stuck. You know, to start a job and to know that this is not what you want to do. This is not where you want to go. But next thing you know, you're 15, 10, 20 years into the job and you feel stuck. Okay? I want to talk to you about how I left my job and came back to Haiti. Was that easy? You know, someone who's watching this video might feel like, "Oh, you know what? You know, that's easy." Please take away anything that, any preconceived idea that you may have about someone. So don't look at my video and believe that I have everything going on for me. I'm a risk taker. In order for you to see the fruits of your result, in order for you to pursue your passion, you actually have to take the steps, okay? So I really wanted to talk about that. Everything is going to be off my mind. If I feel like I'm going to edit a couple of things, perhaps, perhaps not. So the first thing that I want to talk to you about, I actually going to relate this video to myself. Okay, how do you leave a job? And this is I'm going to try to do this and for working adults and for people who have probably bills and, you know, and for people who don't. The first thing is you really have to, when you enter a job, and hopefully it is a profession, it's not a job. Hopefully it is not an apprenticeship. It's, you know, if it is just that, if it is a job, you have to treat it as a job. A job meaning you're getting this to gain as what it is, a job. It is a job that you're probably doing to build a particular skills that you have. It is a job that you're probably doing to help you with income, but you cannot wrap your life around a job. And when you enter a job, you as an employee has a 3 month period, but it is also these 3 month period, it's a period for you to analyze and to see, is this going to be a place where I want to spend another 6 months, another year, another 2 years? If it's not, then you have to start preparing your step to leave. I feel like people become comfortable in a job such as, you know, the lady was talking about, and, you know, we become comfortable in a job when we start wrapping our life around our pay, when we start being very afraid to leave this job and to go back outside in the world and to, you know, start looking for employment. Lord knows these days it takes a lot to put yourself out there and to you know, start looking for work. But if you know how to build your resume and you feel like you have a solid resume, you know that you have a lot to offer to another company, what is it that you have to stay stuck into one place and become miserable? See, in January, I was so angry at myself. I was angry at myself because I should have been in Haiti in January. But I think I got caught up, not only with the paycheck, but with overthinking my move. There are certain decisions that you're going to have to make that you can't overthink them. There are certain decisions that you have to make that you literally have to jump. You have to take the step and just do it. You can't overthink about certain things that you're doing. Certain opportunities only come once in life. And if you're not catching these opportunities, then what ends up happening is you're going to miss on opportunities. And of course, you know, I always say don't rush things, but if you keep missing on opportunities after opportunities, then the next day you won't have anything left for you anymore. You're getting older. You're getting, you know, we are all getting older. Something that's how people become bitter when you, for the younger people who are watching this video, you know, when you are at a job and your supervisor is hating on you, as she is low-key, maybe the person is seeing all the potential that you have at such a tender age, at such a, you know, young age, and the person is not coaching you enough to become the best you because they realize that you have a lot more potential than they have, and because they also realize that, you know what, I could have done that. I could have been like her. But they miss their boats. They miss their opportunities being caged behind a job. Stop doing this, because right now this is a changing world. The economy is going to change. We don't know this whole entrepreneurship thing, if it's going to allow any, you don't know if in 2 years you're going to have what is available now to build on your own business, to take on your craft and turn it into, you know, something that you want to do. You don't know, because times have changed and times will change. I know, and I see how people who were middle class people are barely making ends meet. So that means that in another year or two, you know that things are really going to change. So if you don't position yourself in such a way so that you're going to end up doing something that you enjoy and making a life out of it, being comfortable with what you're doing, having enough to for yourself, for your family, and a little extra, where are you going to fit in this new world order? Where are you going to fit in this new world? You're not going to fit anywhere. You're not. And the reason why you're not going to fit anywhere is because you are not taking the steps now that is going to propel you for the future. It is very important for you to understand this world that we have right now. A lot of people are sitting there are bullshitting, you know, or they're caged behind a paycheck. The paycheck that you're earning right now that you feel is enough for you, in the next 6 months, that paycheck is no longer going to be enough. Think about that. So I'm going to cut this out because I want to talk to you about what you need to look for and to feel like, okay, you know what, it's time for me to move on. It's time for me to really either jump or it's time for me to get another job. So we'll talk about that. I don't want to make this video too long. So stay tuned for the next. Thank you for watching.